Hiya.
Yes. Fight distancing. This is a concept lesson, so I'm not actually going to show you anything, but once I explain this, you'll be glad that I did. Take this for example. I'm 6'2", which means I'm taller than most people, and I already have long arms even for my height. So that means I can hit people from further away than they can hit me. And I need to use that as an advantage. Why would I fight on a level playing field if I don't have to? If I can strike somebody from further away than they can hit me, I should just be able to kind of stay outside and use my range to slowly pick them apart. That's good for the tall guy. Now, a shorter guy has to fight with a shorter distancing, and he has to build himself a style that kind of correlates with that. If he needs to get in tight, if he has to get within my long range in order to hit me, that's something that he needs to take into consideration when starting his practice in general. So if you're 5'6 or 5'7, you need to learn how to fight the short guy fighting game if you want to win in a street fight. Now, if you're close enough to me that I can reach out with my fist and I can hit you in the face, then you are in the critical zone of my punch. The critical zone basically refers to the distance in which that guy can reach out and hit you, or you can reach out and hit him. Now, you have to bear in mind, every strike is going to have its own critical zone. So if you fight a guy who doesn't use kicks, he has a much smaller distance than a guy who will reach out and throw a foot in your face, which I will if you let me. So the point that I'm trying to make is that different strikes have different critical zones, and you need to stay outside of that guy's critical zone until it's time to hit him. At which point, you move in, you hit him with ideally the longest strikes you can, and then you move back out of the critical zone. That keeps you safe. It's an entry, a combination, or a strike, and an exit. The next thing I want to say about distancing is that using the maximum amount of distance makes you the most powerful that you can possibly be. Think about this just from a leverage standpoint. I don't want to get too sciencey on you, but think about it like this. Anytime you're doing a bench press or if you're doing push-ups, you always fail when your arms are at 90 degrees because that point right there is the worst leverage position that in which you can be. That said, if you get the bench all the way up, or if you get past that sticking point, it's always like, and then the rest of the lockout is pretty easy. The same thing can be said about a punch. If you hit somebody, or a kick, if you hit somebody with the last 2 inches of your punch, your arm is guaranteed to be straightening out. It's not going to get stifled. It's not going to get stuck in that sticking point, in that weak leverage point, because you use distance effectively to build more strength. Also, more distance equals more speed. My fist gets to pick up more speed on my way to hitting my target. So now I have better leverage and I have higher velocity for my strike. Those are two recipes for success when hitting somebody. And the final thing I need you to realize about distancing is that you need to practice it. I see so many people in the boxing gym, they're hitting the heavy bag and they're just like, ugh, blah, 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 and they throw these 6-inch punches. And any of my trainees that I catch doing it, I ask them, I'm like, when was the last time that you were fighting somebody and their head was like 8 inches away from you? It just doesn't happen. You have to simulate a real fighting environment. And also take this into consideration. If you're fighting as long as you possibly can with long strikes, your arms have to move further in order to hit somebody, and that's going to make you more tired. You have to exert more effort to throw your arm all the way out there and to pull it all the way back in. So that's going to play a role, and if you don't practice that, if you're not actively hitting a heavy bag or whatever, hitting the air, shadow boxing with long strikes, when it actually comes time to throw long strikes in a fight, you're going to be dead tired, or you're just not going to be able to do it at all. Distance equals safety, power, speed, and fatigue. To effectively illustrate those points in a way that you might possibly remember it better, we've prepared this ridiculous little segment.
Hiya!
Ah!
Hey, if you want more videos on how to beat the crap out of people using different MMA styles, I have an entire video series free at howtofightnow.com. So you can either click the link in the video description box or type that crap up in your browser. Either way, go to the website. The videos are free. And if you have any questions, you can ask me in the forum. See you there.